This is the Friday Afternoon Kiss Ovilock Network. And now let's check in and see if Charlie, K1GZL, is on frequency to bring us up to date on the latest 40-meter band propagation. Charlie QTH is up north in northern New Hampshire, near the Canadian border. Charlie, got a copy?
Yes, Jim, a beautiful copy, about 15 over 9, direct, and I hope you're copying me okay. It's raining and 47 degrees, and my power output is down considerably, go ahead.
Roger, I'm copying you on my local loop at about a 7. You're about 7 dBs above my noise level. And how much reduced power are we talking about, Charlie?
Somewhere between 500 and 600 watts. Normally I'm about 1,100 on this frequency if it's dry, but it's not. Okay.
Okay, that you're copying okay. I did have a nice contact with Captain Mike yesterday morning as he was heading east from Sacramento, California. He was at 33,000 feet. 33,000 feet with a tremendous tailwind. I think about 170 knots or over 200 miles per hour. He was passing over the ground at over at nearly 700 miles per hour. And I believe he was near Fort Collins, Colorado. And I think I have a tape of him, and here it is, I hope.
Whiskey Charlie, fly level 330 into right over north eastern Colorado, about to enter into Nebraska. And looks like we're showing that 1,300 miles from Philadelphia. Philadelphia at 1745 GMT. And the temperature up here right now is minus 40. K1GZL from K4 Whiskey Charlie.
Okay, here's the morning.
We're doing 100, we have 151 knot tailwind, and we're just now have a ground speed of 607 knots, so we're moving along pretty well there. The total time was about 4 hours and 20 minutes, so the average speed of the whole entire route is a 90 knot tailwind, so should get arriving into Philadelphia quite earlier than usual. Thank you, Charlie.
Okay, now that was Captain Mike, and I have one recording here of Ian this morning, and then Captain Mike operating remote from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, where he landed, and he's leaving for Sacramento at 6, a little after 4 o'clock, and I'm picking him up at 6:30. But here is Ian talking a little bit about the COVID-19 situation. And then the Captain Mike remote. He's in Philadelphia when you hear him there. So here it is.
We're up to site is going at the moment. A few cases that the restrictions are very extreme. I think the curfew is still in place. People from Melbourne are not allowed to come to the country, it's having quite an impact, economically. A lot of people, like hairdressers, can't operate. Many businesses are closed. Where I am, we've got to wear a mask, and if we travel into Melbourne, we need a permit. Authorization that what we're doing is essential, so it's not a big problem. But the thing is, not much COVID-19, it's got a little pop to pop, but there's not too much of it going on at the moment, Charlie North, over.
Here comes Captain Mike.
I'll see you there. And incidentally, just as we were talking, I got a email from the FCC, and it looks like the Dot Herb Entity call sign, so the new call sign now is.
Okay, now that was Mike in Philadelphia on remote through his own remote location in Southwest Virginia. I know that's a long one. I should not have gone so long, Jim. I apologize. KC9VKV, I hope you copied K1GZL.
Roger, Roger, Charlie. Just out of curiosity, now you're running the 7300, Roger.
The 7300, Roger.
Roger, Roger, I am.
Do you use filter one position, position one filter?
Position one filter.
Roger, Roger, I am right now.
Yes, sir. That is a full band. It's actually no no filtering, but they couldn't figure out how to say no filtering, so they just called it filter one. But in that filter mode, that 7300 will receive audio way down below 100 cycles if the station that you're communicating with is using that much bandpass on the low end, Roger.
Yeah, I've had very good luck with it, Jim. Very good luck with it, and I'm hoping and praying that everything will continue. I'm looking forward to getting some number 10 cable in here. What I've got is too long in number 12, and my regulation is not too good. Not too good. So, Jim, I won't hold it any longer and give you a chance to work other stations. Thank you for picking me up. But when it rains like this, and it may turn to snow late tonight, it may. It's about a 50-50 on that. And it could accumulate a little bit, especially toward morning, as a low pressure has been developing and will pass into the western Gulf of Maine, probably about 150 miles south and east of here. As it goes by, so it may pull in just enough cold air. Yesterday, it got up to 71 degrees. The normal high is 48, and it got up to 71. So, Jim, I'll say 73, and here's how you're coming in.
It looks like Katie got her vanity call sign, so her new call sign now is...
Here we go.
Is using that much bandpass on the low end, Roger.
Okay, Jim, I'll turn it back to you, and I won't hold it any longer, and I'll try to get you next Friday. KC9VKV, K1GZL.
All right, Charlie, 73 up that way, sir. Thanks for all you do, and the recordings are very, very interesting. We'll see you next Friday if all goes well. This is the Friday Afternoon QSO VLOC Network. My name is Jim, sometimes known as Dr. VKV, and we're recording now live till 5, and then we'll post it up on YouTube so you can come by later and do a call letter search for KC9VKV, followed by today's date, which is 10-16-20. We'll do that, and that'll take you directly to this recording. Or you can do a KC9VKV call letter search only, and that will take you to our QSO VLOG page, where we're now featuring about 1,330 QSO VLOG aircheck recordings. So if you've got a radio you want to check out, give us a shout.